What's up guys, Ethereum Architects here. ArchKit and other softwares develop themselves each year and we expect too much from a software. Instead of that, we can turn back and improve what we have and gained. For example, in the architectural visualizations, instead of showing up a simple render, we can emphasize our building's features so that we can get more attractive visualizations and presentations. Today's topic is this, and I will show you how you can make something like this. But before beginning the tutorial, I would just like to ask you to like this video. It's very important for the YouTube algorithms, as for the channel of course. It will help to see more people to see our tutorials and help the channel growing up. Okay, without any further ado, let's get into the ArchKit. Our sample building is this, and we are going to use 3D section lines, but they are not visible. As you can see, we only have these guidelines. To make this 3D section icon visible, we are going to use this icon, this 3D cutaway. And you will see it has already been cut. We can get rid of that by directly clicking it, and you will see this trash icon, and we are going to click that. There we go. We are going to cut this building with two directions. One of them will be this direction, one of them will be this direction from left to right. So we have a scissor here. Let's click that. And I want to see a stair, something like this. There we go. And also, we are going to use this one. Maybe something like this. Now we are going to click this finalize. And this is what we have. We have cut the building. And after this stage, you may want to change the camera angle from the settings. You can change this view cone. It was previously 110. I've changed it to 80. Or instead of that, you can click this parallel projections and click OK. And you will see an axonometric view. There we go. We can use this camera angle. Now we are going to set up our sun position. So we need to see some sun shadow. With this 3D, we are going to right click it and 3D styles, turn on sun shadows and click OK. At this stage, I want to see some light to come inside. So again, we go to settings and you will see this sun symbol. Let's change its position to bottom right angle. Let's click OK. There we go. We can use this and render with this sun settings. We can make this render two additional way. One of them is directly going to documents and by clicking creative imaging, and you can click this photo render projection, or you can right click here, open up this 3D visualization settings, and you can show up this photo rendering settings. We have this photo rendering settings now, and we can change its settings. For instance, if you want to change this environment, you can make this HDR right or physical sky. We have predetermined sky options here. And as for the time location, use ArchKit sun position, bottom right position. But most of all, we have two very important settings, the quality, this one, and render size. I want to increase this render size, for instance, from settings, this 3840 to 2160. Let's click that and click render. There we have our render. We can look closer. By the way, I am very happy with the resolution and the quality of the rendering. You can see these reflections, border, and other ambient occlusions, and like that. Anyway, now we are going to save this to our computer. Let's just right click and click save as. Let's click save. And we are gonna re-import to our project. Let's close this window. And we go to our layout book and create a new layout with this icon, new layout. As for the master layout, you can use any type. For instance, we can go with this A3 landscape. And I'm gonna make this 3D section model and create. This is our layout, but if you want to get rid of these red lines and arcade icon, you just go to this A3 landscape, or you can duplicate, double click it, use the arrow, select them all, and hit delete. And we can go back to our 3D section model layout. And now it's clear. Now, after this stage, we are going to import our picture. We just go to file menu and external content and place external drawing. In the opening window, we are going to select our saved render and hit open and place somewhere here. As you can see, our resolution is too big. That means if we print this, we will have very good quality printing. Anyway, let's hit Ctrl plus D and click title. Make this no title. Click OK. Now we won't see this title anymore. By clicking corners, we can resize it. In the opening window, we can use stretch like so. We are going to align this to our layout. And cut. For instance, I don't want to see this part, so I just click the edge and use this offset edge and offset inside. Like so. Now we are at the point where our tutorial aims. Now we will highlight the features of our building. First of all, I just want to say we are going to use lines. Document. We are going to use this line tool. And also you can change its color to make it more visible, something like this. And overline on the render. For instance, I want to see these stairs, but I don't want to see this basement. So I'm going through on this wall to ceiling. Then I want to show this living room and this bedroom. Therefore, I'm gonna come through to this position and cut out the window like so. If you don't want to see the roof, you can make as I did. Since this was an axonometric view, as you can see, our up lines will be totally 90 degrees. Also, I'm gonna cut these doors and this outside. By the way, if you don't want to see these roads, you can hide it and re-render your building. There we go. Maybe we can fix this point position. I don't want to see ugly parts of the building. Okay. After this stage, we can determine any other line type under the options menu. Element attribute is dense color. And I'm gonna select this one and change the pen weight to 0.8. Click OK. And I'm gonna select all of the lines and assign our new pen type to them. But actually we cannot see the thickness of the lines. In order to see the thickness of lines, we just go to the view on screen view options. We're gonna check on true line weight. There you go. After this stage, we are going to divide this render to additional parts. Why are we doing this? Because we are going to use Magic Wand tool, but ARCAD sometimes cannot read the middle of our center points of the magic wand. For instance, if I click this corner and hit the minus, subtract from polygon, and if I hit the space, now you will see this part will be selected. If we had not done the division operation here, we wouldn't have been able to perform this operation. There we go. Now we can get rid of these lines, hyper lines, and move our render to the center of the layout. Or maybe we can hit Ctrl plus K and resize according to our layout sizes. I'm very satisfied this model has turned on, and we can maybe improve adding more lines like so. It's up to you. Maybe you can extend. And you can get more attractive sections. In addition to that, if you want to bring this one step further, you can just duplicate your render to the right. And you can click the fill, hit space, and click onto that. And you can bring to its previous position and change its position and right click, display order, send to back. After that, you can use any fill type, for instance, 25%, and you can use any kind of black and uncheck this outline type like so. Or you can just go with the bold black. Some kind of a shadow. Anyway, you get the point. Maybe we can change this scale. There we go. And readjust according to our layout. After this stage, you can always add more text or helper lines to your render. For instance, we can add here pool, swimming pool, and we can use sublines, maybe like so. A living room text here. yani bir çizik boyutlu bir bedroom. And attic here. Anyway, you get the points. You can do whatever you want. Alright guys, this is how you can create 3D section model and how you can improve your architecture representation and make them more attractive. I hope you have enjoyed by watching this video. If so, please like this. It's very important for YouTube algorithms and of course it's going to help this channel to growing up. If you want this project file, you will see this and also my other project files in my Patreon page. You will also see other video tutorials special for Patreon supporters. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.